Hello everybody, I'm glad that you're here. Apple just announced the Apple Vision Pro device. It's a device that I'm super excited about, and normally I would never make a video on a device that I don't have in my hands, because I can't really offer you an unbiased review of something that I haven't used. And any footage that I would show you of the device would just be marketing material that you can find on your own on the Apple website. So why am I making this video? Because I haven't been this excited about a device since maybe the iPad version 1. And specifically, I'm excited about the potential of this device in education. It has the ability to have very high quality video. In the demos, they even showed the dissection of a heart. They showed things like engineering work. All of this would be fantastic in an educational setting. But there is a reason why I think the Apple Vision Pro might not be great for an educational setting. And in Apple's sort of not defense, I don't need to defend Apple, they can make their own decisions, but in sort of looking at what Apple's doing, they're not releasing it till next year. So usually if it was going to be geared towards an educational market, you'd see a September release. But in this case here, they're releasing it next year, and it is called the Vision Pro, which also makes me think there may be some other models coming for September of the following year, not this year, but this following September. Anyways, what is it that I think makes this particular device, as I've seen it so far, not well suited for education? Unlike some of the other headsets, and I have videos here on the channel where I talk about using those in education. It's not the price. You might think, oh, well, it's very expensive. How can we possibly afford those for all the students? Well, we have a lot of devices and a lot of technology that's in a school that is expensive, but it's shared amongst multiple students. So for example, we can buy a very expensive overhead projector and use that in a classroom, and that cost is justified because it's used by many students. This is what I think is potentially the most challenging aspect of the Apple Vision Pro in education, is that it seems to me to be one of the most personalized devices that I've ever seen. It seems to be something that is going to be tied directly to the individual, not just from a shape of your head and making sure that it's a customized fit for your head, having the glasses in there so that it's customized for your vision, but also the configuration of the device to look at your face and your eyes to make sure that it works with you. And that's fantastic for an individual user, but it's not going to be a device that we can share amongst multiple students, which brings us back to needing one device per student on a one-to-one ratio. So as fantastic as this device is in terms of capabilities, in terms of, you know, the quality of the video, the audio, the immersive experience, the things that could really, really make it fantastic in school, I think probably that one-to-one ratio is something that might be challenging, if not impossible, to do with every student, especially because we're unlikely to put a student into a virtual environment for a full school day. It might be something where they would want to use it a couple times a week. Perfect for a device that's shared, not so perfect for a device that's highly personalized. So that's my take on the Apple Vision Pro in education at this point. I will be looking to get one when they do get released. So make sure you like, subscribe, and you can even hit the super thanks if you want. But I'm going to hopefully be getting one of those devices when it's released, and I'll be breaking it down from an educational standpoint and looking at how it could be a useful tool in educational technology. And it is important to note that when I'm talking education, I'm specifically looking at, you know, kindergarten to grade 12, maybe some college courses. In highly specialized engineering or medical education, the price would not be an issue to train a doctor. We could get one for every doctor trainee. We could get one for every engineering trainee. That would be a reasonable cost in light of how much tuition would be for those fields. But for regular educational use, I'm very interested to see if we either see a ability to share one device amongst many students, or if another device is released that's not the pro level, but is at a price point where we could go with a one-on-one ratio. So I'm super excited about the device. Just wanted to make this quick video, share my thoughts with you. What do you think about the Apple Vision Pro in education? Now, VR in education, check out some of my other videos on VR in general in education, which I think is a good thing. But specifically, what do you think about the Apple Vision Pro in education? Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.